Instructors visit each of the Jays' minor league teams. St. Catharines is their last stop. Mel Queen is here to assess both the players and the coaching staff. He's looking for rising stars.
I think a good base stealer has got to be arrogant. You got to defy them to stop you.
And Shannon's got the kind of speed. He can do that. He's got great acceleration.
Wow. He's got excellent acceleration. Probably the best in the organization.
And he wants to be perfect. He doesn't want to make outs. He wants to be 100 for 100. He doesn't want to be 85 for 90, you know.
When he's running, he has control of the situation. Prior to his running, he feels the pitcher has control. And once he gets a little confused by the pitcher, now he goes into a little shell and becomes defensive rather than being aggressive.
Mel Queen is the head man. He's the one that makes all the decisions. When he comes in town, if he's telling us something, I pay attention.
Shannon Stewart, you've got outstanding speed. We're in a tie game in the bottom of the ninth. Now, if you're going to steal third, you got to make sure you can make it in that situation. But the very first time you get on second base, and it may not be a steal situation. So you're out there. Just watch and see what they're using. They might be using second sign, third sign, whatever. But those are things as a base runner and a base stealer like you are, you've got to concentrate on. We've gone over this with the base runners before.
He was talking about stealing third, right, picking up signs from the catcher. That could make you a better base stealer. He's been around the game for I don't know how many years to teach me to do something what I've been trying to do for 15 years and it takes this man 2 minutes. That's saying something.
Contact. If the ball's hit back in the pitcher, you're dead. The ball's hit to the third baseman, you're dead.
I had a bad read. I thought it was hit harder. And I made a bad base running mistake right there.
Once in a while, I still hear his voice. That one in a million sound, like two laughing boys. He would hate it if we cried. That never was his style. Oh, we still miss him every once in a while.
Mel's most memorable moment was to occur in 1967 when he was to get his first start on April 16th against the San Francisco Giants. Mel went out and pitched a complete game shutout, allowing just 6 hits and struck out 8 Giant batters, including all 3 batters he faced in the ninth, Jesus Alou, Kid Anderson, and Norm Seaver. On May 16th, Mel pitched the gem of a game against the Pirates, a complete game win that featured throwing 8 scoreless innings and striking out 9 batters. For his first start and successful performance during the month of May, Mel was named the Sports Illustrated National League Player of the Month.
Remember when
ones died newborn. Life was changed, disassembled, rearranged. We came together, fell apart, and broke each other's hearts. Remember when? Dance to week to week, brought back the love. We found trust, vowed we'd never give it up. Remember when? Remember when? 30 seems so old now, looking back.
First pitch.
You tell him. No, he
didn't. That was good, Dad. We need this. We need
more of
these. Three
winnings.
I was going.
Remember when we said when we turned gray, when the children grow up and move away, we won't be sad, we'll be glad.
Okay, here I come.
For all the life we've had.
Chief Nakataka. We gotta go, Kaka.
Rocky, you're gonna drink more Sunny D, dude?
I'll pour it, Rocky.
Okay, Rocky. Hey. Jack, here's the blue.
We said when we turn gray, when the children grow up and move away, we won't be sad, we'll be glad for all the life.